The ALU we are going to build is capable of performing 18 functions on two 16-bit values. However, we don't need to worry about implementing the functions themselves. Instead, we'll focus on manipulating the inputs, the operations performed on them, and the resulting output. This approach allows the ALU to perform all 18 functions using simple operations. The manipulation of the bits are controlled by 6 control bits. The ZX and NX bits modify the X input, while the ZY and NY bits modify the Y input. The modified inputs are used in the operation determined by the F input. The output can then be further modified by the NO bit, giving us the final result. Additionally, the ALU provides more information about the final output using the status bits. Let's begin by discussing the control bits for the X input. According to the specifications, ZX, when enabled, sets all bits of X to 0, while NX, when enabled, negates or flips all the bits of X. Enabling both ZX and NX sets all X bits to 1, and when both control bits are disabled, the input remains unchanged. To implement the ZX control bit, we can create a truth table. The output is true only when Z is false and X is true, which leads to a simple straightforward Boolean expression and circuit. Similarly, we can create a truth table for the NX control bit using the output of the ZX circuit as its input. The truth table resembles that of an XOR gate, so its Boolean expression is also straightforward. Combining both circuits gives us the final circuit to modify the X input as necessary. Alternatively, we could have created a truth table with both control bits and obtained the same result through simple Boolean manipulation. We can apply the same obtained circuit to the Y input using the ZY and NY control bits. The F control bit determines the operation on the inputs. Creating a truth table for F with all possible combination of zeros and ones would be tedious, considering the 16-bit inputs and the complicated add operation. Instead, we can use the result of both operations as inputs. When F is 0, the output is the result of the AND operation. When F is 1, it is the result of the add operation. This gives us the Boolean expression for the F control bit, and we need the result of both operations to obtain the final circuit. Now, let's discuss the final control bit, NO. When NO is disabled, the output does not change. When enabled, the output is negated. Therefore, we need an XOR gate to create the circuit. We are almost done. We just need to provide appropriate information about the output using the status bits. Starting with the ZR bit, it is set to 1 when the output is 0, indicating that all the output bits are 0. In the truth table, the output will only be 1 for the first row. We can achieve this by using an OR gate that combines all the output bits and then applying a final NOT gate. For the final bit NG, it is set to 1 when the output is a negative value, otherwise it is 0. The ALU uses the 2's complement form of binary numbers, where all negative numbers have 1 as the most significant bit. Therefore, we can use the MSB as the NG output of the ALU. We then combine all obtained circuits. This completes our ALU design. Now let's move on to implementing the code in HDL for the nand2tetris project. But before that, we'll make some modifications because the circuit right now will result in many internal pins and long code. For example, we don't have an XOR 16 chip, so we have to either use 16 XOR chips or substitute it with NOT 16 and 16 and OR 16 gates. If you recall the implementation of the F control bit, you might recognize that we can use a chip called multiplexer, specifically a two-way multiplexer, to achieve the same result. We can apply this approach not only for the F control bit, but also for the inputs and output. Let's start with the input X. This time, we can create a truth table using the variable X self as the input. This gives us 4 variations of inputs. We can say that the 2 control bits select among these 4 inputs. Therefore, we can use a 4-way multiplexer here, with the variations as inputs and the control bits as selection pins. To obtain the negated X signal, we can use a NOT 16 gate. The first input of the multiplexer is connected directly to the input X, the second input to the negated X signal, the third input bits are connected to zeros, and fourth input bit to ones. The ZX and NX control bits are connected to the selection input. The order of connections should match the truth table order. The output is then connected to an internal pin named A. The same process is repeated for the Y input, and the output is connected to internal pin B. We use an AND16 chip to perform the AND operation on the pins and connect the output to another internal pin named A and B. We perform the ADD operation using an AD16 chip and connect it to A and B internal pin. Now we can connect the two pins to a multiplexer as inputs. We connect the F signal as the selection input and connect the output to an internal pin named O. To obtain the negated output, we use a NOT16 chip which takes the output O as input and provides the NOT O signal. Both the NOT O signal and output O can be set as inputs to a multiplexer. We set the NO signal as the selection pin, and the output is the final output of the ALU. However, we also need to process this output to obtain the status bits. Starting with the negative status bit NG, we can directly connect the MSB of the output to it. For the ZR bit, we don't have a built-in chip that can perform the OR operation on each bit of the 16-bit input. However, we do have an OR 8-way chip that can perform the OR operation on an 8-bit input. We can use multiple instances of this chip to perform the 16-bit OR operation. We split the output into two halves of 8 bits, connecting the lower half to an internal pin named OUT8LSB and the upper half to an internal pin named OUT8MSB. We then connect the OUT8LSB as an input to an OR 8-way gate and connect the output to an internal pin named OR8LSB. We perform the same process for the OUT8MSB, connecting it to an internal pin named OR8MSB. Finally, we use a simple 2-bit OR gate on these two internal pins to obtain the OR result of all the 16 bits of the output. We name the internal pin OR16OUT. To generate the ZR output bit, we use a single bit NOT chip. To confirm that the ALU performs all the functions successfully, we run the test simulation. With this, we have completed ALU and therefore Project 2 of the nand2tetris series.